To do this practice, you may need a bolster or a few pillows, some smaller ones, and if you have it with you, some yoga blocks or something to double as yoga blocks. A few blankets will be handy as well. We begin today's practice on our backs in Savasana. Make sure that you are well supported. Bring the floor up to you. Place a pillow under your head, perhaps a rolled up blanket or a small pillow under your knees so that the back is nice and supported. Allow the entire body to relax. Soften your jaw and your cheeks. The main objective of this practice today is to relax. Zero in on your breath. Allow your belly to rise and fall gently in a steady wave with each inhale and each exhale. Allow your breath to move through your entire body, smooth and steady. Continue to soften your facial features as you relax your cheeks and allow your tongue to fall away from the roof of your mouth to soften your jaw. Allow gravity to do the work for you. Feel your collarbone become wider. Feel those hips settling. Feel the legs and arms grow heavier. Allow yourself to grow heavier and sink deeper into your mat. Throughout this entire practice in your restorative yoga, allow long periods of silence to keep you connected to your practice. Keep bringing yourself back to the different sensations of your breath. It could be the depth of your breath, the sound, the sensations of the air moving in through your nostril, drawing in, and the temperature of the air drawing out. If your mind wanders, that's okay. Bring your mind back as often as you need to. Try not to judge or criticize. This is often the most challenging thing in our yoga practice, so you are not alone. Continue to relax in your Savasana. Begin to make your way out of Savasana. Start by wriggling your fingers and your toes. Rotate your wrists and ankles. Small movements. Keep your upper body relaxed as you draw your feet in a little closer towards the hips. Flex and point 1 foot at a time. And then very carefully Let both knees drop side to side in a very controlled windshield wiper movement. At the same time, you could also let the head drop side to side in gentle movement. And then very carefully make your way up into seated position. We're going to set ourselves up for our child's pose next. To do this, you can make use of some blocks or some pillows to set it up so that your bolster or your pillow is at an incline. Here I'm using a couple of blocks, a pillow. And a bolster. If you don't have a bolster, you can also make use of a rolled up blanket and just create a little bit more support for the body. Take your knees out a little wider, bring the toes together. Allow your body to drape over the props. Create lots of support. If you find this hard on your legs, you can also place an additional blanket between your thigh and your calves. This way, you have a little cushioning in that area. Place one cheek on your pillow or your blanket. Halfway through, I'll let you know so that you can switch to the other side and make it even. Allow your arms to rest comfortably under your chest, treading it in between the hole that you've created. And relax. Breathe deep into your low back. Let your breath wrap around the entire back of your body. We do stay here a little longer for our restorative poses. However, if your body gives you the signal that you need to come out of the pose, please make sure that you do. You are welcome to modify the pose or just come out and rest entirely. The main focus is breath, calming down the mind, focusing on relaxation. In our restorative yoga, it's not as much about doing and moving, more about just being. We're halfway through our child's pose. If you have one cheek down on your prop, lift the head off of the prop and place the other cheek on the prop instead. Once there, allow yourself to grow heavy and trust your prop. Feel supported, giving yourself the permission to let go of the physical body, of the brain, of the mind. Find that state of being instead of doing. As with all our restorative yoga poses, we come out of this one slowly. Carefully unwind your arms and press your way off of your props. Take some time to stretch out those legs. A little massage to the back line of the legs might feel really good. Some windshield wipers, letting both knees drop side to side. And we're going to get ready for our next pose, which is supported bridge pose. To do this, you need to have a little bit of lift for the hips. But make yourself comfortable. Set up a pillow under the spine and perhaps a couple of blocks of small pillows like I have here and a rolled up blanket to create a little lift for the hips. Support the head. Make sure you are very comfortable. And then on your back, you're going to place the props under your hips to lift it up a little. Coming into supported bridge pose. Allow the upper body to relax. And let the knees collapse towards one another. Keep adjusting until you're comfortable. You can get rid of any props if you find it's too much. Stay in this position, or if you feel that you need a little bit more than that, you're welcome to start to walk your feet away from your body. Sometimes this is too much, and if you feel like you only want to do one leg at a time, just keep one knee bent and straighten the other leg like I'm doing here. I will let you know halfway through so that you can switch those legs around. We're about halfway through now. Go ahead and switch those legs around if you have one leg straightened. Once you've done the switch, allow your upper body to relax. Feel those hips sink into your support and breathe. Very, very mindfully start to make your way out of this pose. Start by sliding that straight leg in a little closer towards the body. Let the knees drop towards one another and stay here for a few breaths. Continue to walk your feet in a little closer towards the hips so that you can lift your hips off of your prop. And roll over to one side to come into a fetal position with a slightly rounded spine. Just stay here for a moment. And begin to make your way back up into a seated position. Take some intuitive movements in between these poses, whether it's just simply rolling your head, to stretch out the neck or some windshield wipers. Our next pose is legs up against the wall pose. It's a great gentle inversion. To do this pose, I like having several blankets under my hips, but it's totally up to you. This can be done without anything at all under the hips. A little support and cushioning for the back is really nice as well, and something for the head might feel good as well. Exactly as it sounds, we're going to lift the legs up against the wall. To do this, slide your hips in close to the wall on one side of the body, and then very carefully scoot onto your back and try to shift the hips a little closer towards the wall. You can have your legs straight up against the wall. It's okay if your knees are slightly bent in this pose. Allow the upper body to relax. And then feel the tailbone sink into your blankets under the hips. If this is not enough, keep sliding your hips in a little closer towards the wall, then allow yourself to relax once again and just enjoy this pose. Once again, those legs do not have to be straight, they can be slightly bent. final few breaths. To come out of this pose, slide your feet down the wall. Draw your knees into the chest. Wrap your arms around your thighs for a hug of the knees into a Savasana. Take your time as you roll over to one side. Come into fetal position and just stay there for a moment. Next, we're going to set up for a supported fish pose with the legs in cobbler's position. You can use a bolster to place along the length of your spine. But if you don't have a bolster, you can also make use of a pillow. Set up the pillow at an incline. You can do this with a couple of pillows. You can use some blocks if you need a little bit more height. And I like to place a blanket under the hips as well to create less of a bump where the low back is. As the body starts to cool down in these restorative poses, it might be nice to have an extra blanket to wrap around your legs as well. As we move into our cobbler's pose, if you need support under the knees, go ahead and place a couple of blocks under those knees. Again, pillows can be used as well. Lie down on your pillow. Allow the arms to open up so that you get a gentle opening to the chest, the upper chest. And once you've got yourself set up, feel yourself sink into your props and breathe. Once again, a reminder that if your body gives you the signal to come out of this pose, please feel free to modify or just come out entirely. final few breaths. Very carefully help those knees come back together. And then roll yourself over to one side again, coming into a comfortable fetal position, just resting there once again for a few breaths, softly rounded spine. And press your way back up into a comfortable seated position. We will set up for our next pose, which is the Wheel of Life or Child's Twist. We're going to set up our pillow at an incline once again. Make use of whatever props you have to create that incline. Here I have a couple of blocks and a pillow. You can make use of a few pillow cushions that you have with you as well. To come into this pose, place your right hip against your bolster, your pillow, and have your feet, one knee close to the other, and then allow your body to drape over your prop. The chest faces your prop. Your arms are on either side of the prop. As this is a soft restorative pose, allow your gaze to be at the same side as your knees. And then just relax into this pose. It's a very passive twist for the spine and the low back. Final few breaths. Very carefully, make your way back up to seated, carefully pressing your way up, and then take some intuitive movements. And we're moving into our Wheel of Life or Child's Twist on the other side. So have your knees drop towards the other side and turn your chest towards your prop, towards your pillow or your bolster. Chest is facing that prop and hands on either side of the prop. And go ahead and relax. Allow your gaze to be at the same side as those knees. Final few breaths. Very carefully and mindfully press your way off of your props. Be sure to take some of those intuitive movements once again, windshield wipers, rolling out your neck. We'll start to move props out of the way to set ourselves up for our final pose, Savasana. So we're coming full circle back to the very first pose. As this is our final pose, make sure to support and make yourself comfortable. Grab a hold of any blankets that you need to keep warm. Wear your socks and sweaters if you haven't already done so. Coming into Savasana, I like placing a blanket under the knees. And another really nice thing that you could do to close off in this Savasana is to place a heavier blanket just above your hips, on your hip flexors. Keeping warm by wrapping an extra blanket over the feet might be nice. Get comfortable. Allow your limbs to grow heavy. Soften your face. Relax your shoulders and your arms. Relax your shoulders and your arms and legs. Feel your body grow heavier and sink deeper into your space. And with calm, relaxed body and calm, relaxed mind, enjoy Savasana. Very slowly begin to make your way out of this pose. Start by moving your fingers and toes. Bring sensations back to the body, circling your wrists and ankles. Gently letting the head drop side to side. Slide your feet in closer towards the body. Some windshield wipers with those knees, letting them drop side to side. Then gather the knees into the chest for a roll up. And if you feel like taking that big stretch, take your inhale, stretch from toes to fingertips. Big inhale. And exhale to release. Roll over to the right side, come into a fetal position, and just hold it here. Carefully press your way up into a comfortable seated position. We're getting ready to close off our class. Just taking note of how you feel physically and mentally. See if you can carry this feeling with you throughout the rest of the day, the rest of the week. Thank you very much for joining me today. Namaste.